Hi everybody, welcome to the CSS3 course. In this video, I am going to discuss a topic called Overflow. Before I discuss this topic, I'm going to show you the web page on the right hand side. So you see that I set up a number of paragraphs together with a really big image that cannot be shown entirely on my viewport size currently. So in order to produce this web page, I need this HTML file together with the CSS file. So let me show you the HTML file first. So this HTML file simply contains a division that contains a paragraph which corresponds to the first paragraph on the web page. Then I include another division that includes another paragraph. So this corresponds to the second paragraph on the web page. Then I show you another division that contains another paragraph. Finally, I include a division that includes an image. So for now, this image is too big to be shown entirely by my current viewport width and height. Okay. So in order to produce this web page, I also need a CSS file that helps me create the background color for my paragraphs. So for the first division, I set up the background color. Same for the second division here and the third division here. Okay. So in order to discuss the topic called overflow, I need to set up some dimensions for my background color. So let me go to the first part, which is here. And also I go to the corresponding division called visible. Okay, so in order to change the background color dimension for my visible class, I can do something like this now. Okay, now you can see that my width of the background color is fixed at 400 pixels. And the height of the background color has been set to 100 pixels only. So you can see that the paragraph will go outside the background color. So this part is known as the overflow of the element. So you can see that the overflow would be a bit ugly. So in order to handle the situation of the overflow, there are some keywords for you to use. The first one is called visible. So how can I demonstrate this idea? I can simply set up the attribute value pair now. Okay, the overflow attribute has a keyword called visible. So it is also the default value of the overflow attribute. So it means that the overflow is able to be shown on the element. So you can see that the background color isn't able to extend its area to cover the entire paragraph. So the words here coming from the paragraph is causing the overflow of the elements. So the default value is visible. That means if I just ignore this settings, I'm also able to see the overflow effects coming from my demonstration shown here. Okay, so this is the default value. So even though you don't add this attribute value pair, the visible effect of the overflow is still shown to you. Then the second demonstration goes to another division whose class is called hidden, which is this paragraph. So in order to demonstrate the overflow effect, let me set up the width and height of the background color first. Okay, now you can see that the second paragraph inside the second division is going to have an even severe overflow because my height is only 80 pixels. It means that the background color is even unable to cover my entire paragraph. So the overflow component is basically shown by my highlighted text, okay? So it may be a bit ugly. In order to handle this overflow, we can have one way called hidden value. Let me show you the hidden value effect. Okay, now when I set up the overflow attribute as having the keyword called hidden, you can see that the entire paragraph cannot be shown completely. The portion that is outside the background color dimension is simply cut off. So when I just highlight the characters inside my paragraph, I'm unable to even highlight the words that are hidden by the overflow attribute value pair shown here, okay? So the hidden keyword simply cuts off the part being overflown, okay? So that is one of the options that you can use to handle the overflow conditions, okay? The third situation is going to be shown on my third paragraph, which is this one. Okay, I have a paragraph whose class name is called scroll. In order to show the effect, I need to set up the height and the width of the background color first. Okay, for the third paragraph, my background color is again unable to cover the entire text shown on my third paragraph. So in order to handle this situation, I can have another way other than the hidden approach. So let me do it now. Yes, I can just use the scroll value for my overflow attribute. So what does it mean by the word scroll here? When I use the scroll keyword, I'm able to generate two scroll bars. One for the vertical dimension and the other for the horizontal dimension. So you will have two scroll bars. It is a property of the scroll keyword. So when you use the scroll keyword, we will always produce horizontal and vertical scroll bars, even though they may be unnecessary. So you can see that for the horizontal scroll bar, actually it is unnecessary because we are handling the text content. The text content can simply be arranged according to the width and height of the division. So if you have a lot more text, you can simply generate your text on another row. We don't always need to fix our background dimension horizontally to constrain the display of the text. So this scroll bar is unnecessary in this case, but it is also shown to you because of the application of the scroll value for my overflow attribute. Then I'm going to show you another situation for the overflow condition. So let me go to this image. Now this image is too large to be shown entirely by the viewport width and the height. So if you want to generate some scroll bars to prevent the overflow of the contents, we can do something like this here. So let me set up the width to be only 400 pixels. Now the height is set as 150 pixels, but you will see that the width and the height of the image is still not satisfying the conditions set as here. So in order to satisfy the condition of the width value and the height value, I can have a way to do so by using the overflow mechanism. Okay, when I use the auto value as my overflow control, I'm able to set up my width to be only 400 pixels and the height of my image to be 150 pixels only. So what about the remaining portions that are not shown entirely by such a small area? I simply generate a scroll bar to help me generate the remaining components of my given image. So in order to show every single part of my image in such a small area, I can make use of the scroll bars to help me. So the word auto here will help us produce the necessary scroll bars in order to demonstrate all the content of your element. Okay. So the overflow attribute can have an auto value to help you overcome the conditions of overflow so that you can see all the contents being shown by using the scroll bars correctly. Okay. So we can see that the overflow topic is not that difficult. In order to achieve the overflow effect correctly according to your specifications, you can consider using the keywords like auto, scroll, hidden, and visible. This is the end of the video. If you have any questions about my video, please leave your questions on the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.